Hey everybody, David Burns here, certified master beekeeper. I want to take you into a hive today. I'm coming out of winter, just now getting the old pocket knife out, cutting away the wrap, seeing what the hives are doing. I've been feeding them with my winter bee kind that I invented, and you can see how these hives are just crazy coming out of winter, so strong. All of my hives come out of winter stronger than they go into winter, believe it or not. And you'll see that. And I'm going to make some splits for you and show you how to do that. Let's go. They need to start using their bottom entrance. And it will take them a few days to figure that out. We'll go ahead and take this other piece of foam off as well. Spring has sprung. Now this is a really good time to work bees. They're going to be really confused here because they're not used to the hive looking that way. Look at all the foragers trying to get in with that bright orange pollen on. So. Probably going to be a lot of dead bees on the bottom from winter. Bees die naturally during the winter. So we got to take it off, take the winter bee kind off, and kind of decide if we want to make a split. I'm going to start down below and clean up a little bit down there. And this is interesting. This is just, they're bringing in so much of this pollen here today that it's been falling off the top and it's been falling down all the way down to the bottom. So it's a heavy nectar flow today. The good old winter bee kind. Wow. This hive is so full of bees. They ate all the winter bee kind candy. Now they're confused about where they live, how to fly in and out of the front. Looking good. I want to see if the queen's up here laying in this super. I can pull out the middle frame because in this case I've got 9 frames in this super, so they're not tied up against each other. Slow motion movements. And yes, I know I have bees crawling all over me and they're not stinging me. So we can ask the question, is the queen laying up in the top super? Indeed she is. You can see brood off on the side of the frame. I don't see any more larvae. Everything is capped over. Let's look at this side. So what I want to do now is decide where is my queen. I'd like to find her. So I'm just going to take this frame out for a minute, hang it over here. That gives me more room to move frames around. I want to make sure the queen is not up in this honey super. These frames are really stuck together. Always work in slow motion. And always work your hive from the back of the hive or the side. So by coming out of the winter like this, by feeding them like with my Winter Be Kind, you can see how much brood they can build up. And this was just their ability to do so by being well fed. So my job is to just find the queen. So I'm just going to kind of look around and see if I can locate her. The reason why it's a good time to work these bees today is because there's a heavy nectar flow in the spring right now, and I can work them because they're kind of preoccupied with business. So I'm looking for the queen. I see larvae that's about 4 to 5 days old. So the queen was here 4 or 5 days ago. But I don't see any eggs, so she may be down in the deep supers, but we'll keep looking. A lot of cat brood on this frame here, so the queen is unlikely to be there. I'm not even going to look hard. Wow, that is stuck together with propolis. Using my hive tool to kind of move it gently. Don't make it a jerky movement or the bees that kind of get excited. And they may not go after you, but it might scare you and you'll be afraid to work them if they're kind of flighty. Now, she could be on this one because there's a lot of open brood. So what we'll do is scan for the queen and then look what's in the cells. So I scan real quickly. I don't see a queen. What do I have in the cells? Basically just nectar. I do see a two-day-old egg on top of pollen. So we're closer to the queen. She has not laid any eggs on this frame over here. But they have dried them out for either her to lay or for them to put nectar in, and they are putting some nectar in. So one more look over here for a queen, and nothing. This is real, either you can view this as real tedious work or enjoyable work. It's like fishing. You put a cork in the water and you wait for a bite. You can't rush fishing and you can't really rush beekeeping skills like this. Just looking for a queen. There's bees on my arm and they're just kind of sitting there. And I can tell they're not going to sting me because they're just relaxed. They're not tensed up as they're stinging. So I'm just going to let them sit there. Where is the queen, right? Mostly nectar. Now, it'd be great to find her because then I can continue on with doing what I want to do, knowing where my queen is, but I don't see her yet. So maybe she's on this side over here. We're going to go through these three frames. They're spraying their Nasonoff gland to give a sighting on the new location because I changed what the hive looks like by removing the wrap. And we'll just take a quick glance for a queen. A lot of pollen up here, a lot of nectar. Not a good place for a queen to be laying, but she could still be here. Nothing there. We have Whoa. A queen and we have brood. So let me hold it like this one-handed. So here's the queen. She's not marked. Yeah, the bees are on top of her.
She's huge.
She's a big queen, look at that. And that's her brood that she's laid here, you can see. So now my job is to do something with her. So I'm gonna make a split because this hive is full. So I'm gonna watch the queen. I'm gonna just put this super frame in a deep box. I realize that's going to make some difficult comb. It's going to add some comb to the bottom. But I'm just going to put my queen right there. I'm going to put these frames beside this, these combs, these other frames, because this is the split that I'm making. I'm taking the old queen. And I'm taking this, these nurse bees here, let them go with the queen. There's four frames of bees, but I think my curiosity is pretty strong. So what I'm going to do is take that super off and then look at the next deep below it to see what's there. Just for giggles.